Hello folks, so before we dive in, if you wanted to get a MailButler subscription, you can check the link out in the description. There's a 15% off code. They just let me know while I was editing, so I thought I'd throw that in. Use KeepProductive15 if you actually are interested in this product, but we give a little bit of a tour. So here we go, and let's roll in. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Today I am very lucky to be joined by Luca and George, who are at MailButler. They've got an exciting release, should be releasing today, if we get the video out all on time. But feel free to introduce yourselves, and obviously a little bit about MailButler for those who are maybe total newbies.
Awesome. Hey, so I'm George and this is Luca.
Hey guys.
We're both key account managers here at MailButler. So just tell you a brief introduction about MailButler. So basically, MailButler is a productivity extension plugin for Gmail, Apple Mail, and now after popular demand, we've just released our Outlook version. So basically, with MailButler, it's designed for professionals and businesses to streamline their inbox and help them manage it better, basically.
Fantastic.
And the nice thing about MailButler is that it just seamlessly integrates into your inbox. And it just adds a few key features that we're going to get more into in a bit that helps you boost your productivity, basically.
Lovely jubbly. I think my friend Carl Pauline uses it as his sort of management inside of Apple Mail. And you guys have been really kind because I don't actually have a Windows computer or even just in general office. So you're going to show us around how that looks and how that works. So yeah, feel free to take it away.
Definitely.
Okay, cool. So yeah, like George said, we have many ways. Like we have Apple Mail, we have Gmail, and we have now going on Outlook. The beta is at the moment out, and we will release the official version on the 28th of January. In general, when we use MailButler, there are two ways to do it. The first way is our dashboard. This is kind of like the backbone of the whole thing that we provide. In here, you can actually edit everything that will later on then will appear inside either Apple Mail or Outlook. And I would say let's simply jump into Outlook and I will give you a quick review on the features that we provide. So there we are. I moved this little window so we can see everything. Perfect. Okay, the first thing I want to show you is the message template that you can work with. I'm pretty sure a lot of people know what message templates are. The thing is that you can save a lot of time because sometimes you have to send the same email over and over and over again, and then having templates that have the same information actually can really boost your productivity. If you just pretend you save like 2 minutes with one template instead of writing it, then you would save, like if you send out 15 emails, you would save half an hour. And that's a really good thing. So I will show you here into the Outlook app. If you, for example, go into compose a new email, then you can scroll to the right and you see this little MailButler icon. You just simply click it. And here you can see that the sidebar will open. This is the MailButler sidebar. Every feature is in here. And here, for example, we have the templates. Let's say you have had a call and you want to go into further steps, for example. You send out, you click this template and it will automatically jump into your email. That's a really good thing because it saves you a lot of time. And another thing about this is like what we do, and this is like really what we focus on MailButler, is we have an easy way to share it with teams. Meaning most of our features are easy shareable with the team you create inside MailButler. I can simply show you by clicking on this little icon here on the right side. This shows with which team you have shared this template. The template, for example, if you go to the dashboard, you can easily create message templates by simply clicking in here and create a new template. And then when you have it, you created it, you can simply click on the left side, create, and you can choose where you want to share it. Meaning with your marketing, your sales team, development team. This is cool because then everybody can like really, they can work together on the same template. They can edit it afterwards as soon as it's in the compose email. And this is like one of the features that saves you, that can save you really a lot of time and boost your productivity. The second thing is signature templates. We have it as well on the dashboard. If you click it, you will be able, we have some pre-made ones, you can choose them, or you can do some by yourself. And when you do this, it will save it and you can use it into Outlook. Let's say we use the same email here. We click to the bottom. And then in the right sidebar that I showed you before, we have the signatures that we created. Let's choose that one, maybe the signature one, and it will show the signature in the email as well. So we have enough time savings, and you can also change, like depending on if you have multiple business going on, whatever, it's easy to simply jump in between those. The good thing about this is you can share it with the team as well. So you have a kind of like a branded thingy going on because everyone is really using the same email signature, and it's easily shareable. So let's close the compose window and let's go changes and go into one of our favorite features. Let's say you send an email. Let's take this one. It's a very long one, right? You see there's a lot of information inside. What MailButler provides is a notes feature in the right sidebar. Meaning this, you can simply go into this node and add bullet points. Bullet one. You can go on like bullet two and so on and so on. And this will help you to kind of like summarize long emails. You know, those typical business emails, you get them, there are a lot of information, you need to write down all the stuff, but this will help you to immediately make notes and summarize it because then you don't have to reread it. And just pretend rereading this email will cost you like 1 or 2 minutes depending on your reading speed, and you can save a lot of time with that as well. The cool thing about notes is that when once you made the note, it will only be visible for you unless you share it with the team, which is possible as well. You simply click the button, and everyone who has this email, let's say we shared it with marketing, they are able to see what you actually wrote inside. So when they are in contact, for example, with this person, they can see, okay, what's this email about? So again, this notes feature really, it helps to summarize, it gives you overview, which speeds up your workflow, and it saves you a lot of time, and everyone is actually up to date. So it's a pretty nice, and you see there's a strong team workflow feature. And right next to that, we have the task feature, which is kind of like notes, but not exactly. Let's say, for example, after this email, I need to call Francesco. So I click it. And now I want somebody else, let's say from our sales team, to call Francesco. I share it with the sales team. And they will be able to see the task that is inside this email. So they can click it and they can actually mark it as checked, for example. But also they can set a reminder. If I want to like call you tomorrow, I can simply add date and time, pretty simple. And then it will remind me. And so I will never forget to really call you. So it helps you kind of like, following up on the task that you want to have. Another cool thing, I will not show this to you because it's pretty easy. You can integrate those tasks with like classical productivity apps, like for example, Evernote and Todoist and stuff like that, simply by going to the dashboard and integrating your account to MailButler, and it will update the task to your list, like to-do lists. So I have another thing about, like, I want to talk, like, this is really, MailButler is really, really strong in optimizing the workflow for teams. So the real benefits that you have when using those team features is that you save a lot of time. And this is a huge thing in productivity. And it really helps you to, let's say, structurize and control the emails, the works, and the tasks flow that you have inside your email. And the good thing about it, I mean, that's what we talked about, we have Apple Mail. We have a Gmail integration, and we are now releasing Outlook. So it really works seamlessly. It really goes into and connects with every kind of operating system or app you use it with. And it's a real harmony, I would say. And that's actually really good features. So yeah, that's the part about some of our team features. Fantastic. And George will take over for the next ones.
Yeah, brilliant.
Continue with more, like some key features that we have. So yeah. I'm going to talk about the send data feature. Mm-hmm. So basically with MailButler, can you navigate?
Yeah, of course. Okay.
So yeah, so basically you can also, like, for example, if I want to schedule if I want to send an email, but I'm in contact with someone in the States, for example, and there's a huge time difference with us. So you'd want to communicate with them at appropriate timings. We wouldn't want them to receive the email too early or too late, depending on the time difference. We can simply schedule the email to be sent at a later time. So you can do this after composing the email. You can just go and, like, from the sidebar, and pick the appropriate date and time that you want the email to be sent out on. So that kind of like helps you improve the communications so that you know that the email is sent at an appropriate time and you're not really annoying someone with your email. Yeah. Apart from that, sometimes you want to send an email and at a later time when you might be out of the office, so you can also send and schedule the emails at the appropriate timings. So that's also something that's very useful, I believe. Apart from the send later feature, I'm going to jump into the tracking. So a lot of people, especially like people who work in sales, let's say, really struggle with knowing whether an offer they sent out is has been read, or if the people they're emailing are interested in the offer they're sending. So we have the tracking feature. So basically, if you go to the sent inbox and you open an email, just like WhatsApp, we kind of add like those check marks to the side. So those double, if they're blue and two check marks show up, it means that your email has been opened. So this is kind of open tracking. It just gives you like details if the email has been opened or not. We can also provide you with more details about the opening features. If you just open it up, you'll be able to see the tracking details. This kind of gives you information about when the email was first opened, when it was, the amount of times it's been opened, how many the minutes after it's been opened, how long we waited for a reply. And it also gives you more information about the country, the operating system, and yeah, all the information you need about like an email being tracked. If you scroll down a bit, you can also see links, link tracking. So let's say like I have some links in my signature, or if I provided certain links in the body of the email, you can also see if the recipient opened those links. So that also gives you a lot of valuable insight to see if a customer is kind of interested in opening in an offer or in your emails in general, basically. So those are kind of the key features that we have, the main features that we have, and the most useful ones, I'd say.
And also there's another feature that is pretty nice, I would say. It's like the snooze feature. I use it a lot of times. Snooze means when you get an email inside your inbox and you don't want to take care of that now, like let's say this pitch email, I click it and I click the snooze button, and it will like be dropped into another folder called the snooze, MailButler snooze folder. And it will disappear for a certain time. So it comes back at another time later, but depending on how you set it, you can set that in the dashboard, for example. And this will really help to improve the workflow as well.
Declutters the inbox, basically.
Yeah.
That's it. And it pops up at the right time.
Yeah. Exactly. Exactly.
Fantastic. So, I didn't know that you guys had the ability, if you and your team wanted to have the signatures, because I think that's like a big pain point for consistency if you all wanted to have very similar email signatures. So that's really cool. And I liked all of the other abilities as well. So this is going to go live. If we post on the 28th of January, it'll go live today, right?
Yeah. So the outlook release is due to be set out on the 28th.
Yeah, that's today.
Lovely job.
Currently on the beta version, as you can see up here, there's this little banner.
Oh, yeah.
And we're currently improving to make like the best experience for the users, because we had a lot of them who asked for it to do it on Outlook. Then we decided to actually give it a try. And
fantastic.
Yeah, it looks quite good, I think.
Yeah, definitely. I'm just going to stop sharing the screen and then cut to me and us guys talking.
Oh, wait, before you stop,
Yeah.
I have something that actually, we wanted to tease it only in starting of February, but as soon as you're here, I want to give you a little piece of like a little gift for you and your follower.
Yeah, do it.
Like that, because we are soon releasing a very nice thing that's not yet integrated into the Outlook, but it will come, and it's called Contacts.
Oh,
and this
okay.
will be kind of like something like a CRM, like a customer relationship management tool, but it will not be like that.
Yeah.
So you can be really excited. It will be a really good feature, and it will come out around the 25th of February. And you really can be excited, because this is a very, very nice thing that will come up in the future. Yeah.
That is a nice tease. Thank you, guys.
You're really welcome. You're really welcome.
Yeah, definitely. And out of curiosity, like if somebody after this video was wanting to get started with this, how much is the pricing? Because you've got two or three plans, is it?
We got three plans. We have the essential plan, which is free for all users. And with the essential plan, you get 30 actions, where it's just like you can use all the other features for 30 limited actions.
Yeah.
And we have the professional plan and the business plan. So the pricing for each kind of differs, as you can see here, because you can either pay monthly or yearly. So for monthly payments, for the professional plan, it would be like around 7.95 euros a month. And for the business, it would be 29.95 euros. But if you decide to pay yearly, and that kind of saves you the cost of 2 months, it would be 6.5 euros a month, which kind of adds up to 78 euros per year. And the business would be 24.95 a month, which adds up to 299 euros a year.
Lovely. And the goal is saving people lots of time and effort.
Yeah, because, you know, like in business, like time is money, kind of like, as time is the most valuable gift that we have. And if we can save it, then we have a lot of benefits from that, right?
Yeah, I can see. I see a lot more people spending money on email just because it's such a consumption of our days. It keeps us very busy when we should try to, you know, manage it as well as we can. So thank you both for coming on. I really appreciate it. And I put the pressure on you because this wasn't an average like call. It was you're being recorded.
Yeah,
so, that's good.
You did great, guys. Thank you very much for coming on. And you can check out MailButler in the description below if it interests you. And I'll include any news about there. Also, this release, of course, so you can read the whole announcement. But Luca and George, thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you very much.
Good to you.
Cheers.